Well, good morning. I know there's a lot of excitement, a lot of a buzz going on this morning with excitement over the Christmas program, and so we're glad that each of you are here. Thank you for coming and being here with us. The kids have worked hard on this, and the technical people and all the others, and so I know you're going to be blessed this morning by everything that takes place. So we want you to enjoy this. We want you to remember that though a program like this is very much about the children, yet it's about that special child that was born, the Lord Jesus Christ. And we certainly are hoping that, praying that this will be a special part of your Christmas celebration this year. I just want to read one verse to you, and then Brother John is going to lead us in song, and after that, then we'll have the children come in just a few minutes. So let me just read this to you. It's from the book of Isaiah. And it says, "Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, a virgin will be with child and bear a son, and she will call his name Emmanuel." We praise God that he sent his son that we might have God dwell among us, that he might take on the form of man in order that he might be our sacrifice, that he might be our substitute, so that we might have hope of salvation. So let's bow together for prayer as we begin this morning. And may God be glorified in all that we do this day. Father, we thank you for this gathering of people. We thank you for the children today. Pray that you will bless them. I know they can be overwhelmed with nervousness. I pray that, Lord, every word that they speak, they'll speak for your hearing. And, Lord, that we know then that they will be blessed and we will be blessed by them. So I just pray that, Lord, the marvelous gift that you've given us may be highlighted in everything that happens this morning. We love you and praise you and thank you for this day. And we ask that you be glorified in it. For we pray in Christ's name. Amen.
Stand, join me in worship. Good morning.
Oh, come, all ye faithful, joyful in triumphant. Oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Sing choirs.
Sing choirs of angels, sing in exaltation. Oh, sing all ye citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, all glory in the highest. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Yeah, Lord, we greet thee, born this happy morning. Oh, Jesus, do all glory be given. Word of the Father, now in flesh appear. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him, Christ the Lord. Amen. Joyous strains, Gloria in excelsis Deo. Shepherds, why this jubilee? Why your joyous strains prolong? What the gladsome tidings be, which inspire your heavenly song?
Just a moment. At Open Door Church, we count the time of giving of an offering as part of our worship service. And we do it the way that it appears that they did it in New Testament times, and that is that during this song, our people be coming forward to give their offering. This is certainly an act of worship. Those of you who are guests, you're certainly not expected to participate in this in that fashion, but we do welcome you to continue with us in song. Also, during this Christmas Christmas season, we are receiving an offering for missions. Now, if you, those of you have been praying about this and want to help with this, this goes to support our international missions efforts across the world. And so that there is an offering box back in the corner that today you can put, if you're prepared to give that offering, you can put that in that box today. So what's brought up here is our normal offering. That is for the special Christmas missions offering. So during this song will be when we'll be participating in this offering. Let's bow together again for prayer. Father, thank you for the marvelous gift you've given to us, and thank you for the privilege that we have to show our trust in you, our confidence in you, each week as we come and bring back that portion of what you've given us that you've declared was holy unto you. So God, thank you for this privilege of worship. Thank you for the privilege of participating in worship in this fashion. We pray that you will bless the people. Dear God, that you'd pour out your blessings upon them and meet every need that they have. May you be glorified in us this day as we worship you in this fashion. For we pray in Christ's name.
Fears and sins, release us, let us find our rest in thee. Israel's strength and consolation, hope of all the earth thou art. Dear desire of every nation, joy of every longing heart. Joy to those who look to see the day spring from on high appear. Come thou promise, bride of Jesse, of thy birth we long to hear. O'er the hills the angels singing news, glad tidings of a birth. Go to him your praises bring. Christ the Lord has come to earth. To earth to taste our sadness, he whose glories knew no end. By his life he brings us gladness, our Redeemer, Shepherd, Friend. Gleaming riches without number, born within a cave. Christ was born the Lord of all. Born thy people to deliver, born a child and yet a king, born to reign in us forever, now thy gracious kingdom bring. By thine own eternal spirit, rule in all our hearts alone. By thine all-sufficient merit, raise us to thy glorious throne. Sufficient merit, raise us to thy glorious throne.
You can have a seat.
And I think our Christmas tree looks even better than last year.
Mom, you say that every year. We have the same tree in the same place with the same ornaments, but every year you say it gets better.
I know. There's just something about family tradition that's special. And it's my tradition to say the Christmas tree looks better every year.
Speaking of tradition, Millie, I think it's your turn this year. Are you ready to place the star?
Daddy, not yet. First, you have to read us the story of the Christmas star, remember?
Yeah, Daddy, that's another one of our traditions. Read us the story of the Christmas star, please.
Okay, how could I forget? Thanks, Millie. Let's see what we can learn about that special night long ago when the Christmas star beamed her light to the world. Are you ready? Once upon a time...
Daddy, that's how princess stories begin. This is a real story.
That's right, Millie. I was just checking to see if you were listening. Okay. At the very beginning of time, God, the great creator, made the earth and everything in it and above it, including the sun and the moon and the stars. The great creator then told the stars,
"As I finish making the rest of the universe, I will place you in the sky, for I have a special place for each of you to shine and a special job for each of you to do."
God placed all of the stars in the sky. He hung them one by one high in the heavens and showed them exactly where and how they were to shine for him. One little star was not hung so high and did not shine so bright. But that one special star was not sad or disappointed, for God had told her,
"Twink, I have a special place for you and a very important job, but you will have to wait because now is not the right time."
How long did Twink have to wait, Daddy? Do you think it was more than just one night?
Yes, Kate. In terms of human time, Twink had to wait a very long time.
More than 5 nights?
Yes, Millie, more than 5 nights.
More than 50 nights? More than 500 nights?
Yes, girls. For more nights than I think you or even I are willing to count. You see, Twink and her starry friends have watched from the heavens from the beginning of creation through the ancient times and are still watching today.
Daddy, do you think Twink knew she'd have to wait such a long time?
Well, Kate, God foretold of the great event that would be Twink's great day to shine.
You mean Jesus' birth, Daddy? The great event was Christmas, the day that Jesus was born in Bethlehem. That's what Twink was waiting for.
You're right, Kate, but you're jumping ahead in the story.
That's right. Back to our story. Before Jesus was born, his birth, his mission, his death, and even his resurrection were all foretold by the prophets of the Old Testament. Twink was still a tiny glitter when the prophets' words were spoken and recorded, but she hung in the sky for a long time, waiting and watching God's great plan unfold.
Daddy, what's a prophet?
A prophet is a messenger of God. Prophets were used by God to foretell, or predict, what was to come, and their words are recorded in the Old Testament scriptures.
You mean everyone knew that Jesus was going to be born?
Not exactly. You see, the prophecies were like a patchwork that didn't quite fit together. Even the teachers of the scriptures couldn't quite connect them all.
The scriptures said the Messiah would be from Bethlehem and from Egypt. He would be the seed of a woman and the Son of God. He would be David's descendant and David's Lord. He would reign and he would suffer. The prophets had everyone confused. We watched it all, didn't we?
Yes, Twink, we did. The prophet spoke of the Messiah in strange words. Moses, remember him? God definitely spoke through Moses. Moses said Jesus would be a prophet like himself, someone who would save his people. And we watched Moses speak of the Savior more than 1,000 years before Jesus was born. I remember Isaiah. Now he was a man of God. He spoke hundreds of years after Moses.
And boy, did he have a lot to say. Kinda like you, Twink.
Yeah. Actually, the prophet Micah was my favorite, because he spoke for the poor and downtrodden. I know how he feels.
How about Jeremiah? He was so timid, which is something you don't know anything about, right, Twink?
Oh, you are so funny.
But then God gave Jeremiah assurance that he could be strong and courageous.
The words of the prophets, so confusing at the time, yet so revealing of God's great plan.
Go ahead, Twink. Tell us again about the great plan. We know it's your favorite story.
When God sent the light of the world. It is my favorite story because I played a part. It has all started with the prophets.
Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel.
The days are coming, declares the Lord, will raise up for David a righteous branch, a king who reigns rising and doers right and just in the land.
For
For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. Of the increase of the Lord in peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness. From that time on and forever, the zeal of the Lord will accomplish this.
But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, though you are small among the clan of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, from ancient times.
The Lord is our judge, the Lord is our lawgiver, the Lord is our king. It is he who will save us.
Isn't it fascinating how the prophets told about the birth of a Savior?
Yes, but the words of the prophets also foretold about Jesus' life, how he would come from humble beginnings, how he would create awe and wonder, and then become despised by men before accomplishing God's great plan.
Okay. But let me tell my story. Let me tell about the events leading up to that special day that I was created for, the events leading up to my very important job. It all began with Mary. It was through Mary that we started to see the fulfillment of the prophecies.
I was honored that I've seen become Joseph's wife. He was a good man, and he loved God. Our families lived in Nazareth, a tiny town in Galilee, and we were betrothed to be married. I was a humble maidservant, nothing more, and content to soon to become the wife of Joseph the carpenter. But God had even bigger plans for me. One night, while I was alone in my house, I was surprised to hear the words,
"Greetings, you who are highly favored, the Lord is with you."
I wondered, what kind of greeting could this be, not realizing that an angel was speaking directly to me.
"Don't be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son. You are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end."
The words of the angel were hard to comprehend. I simply asked him, how can this be, since I am a virgin?
"The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Nothing is impossible with God."
I was overwhelmed. What could all this mean? But I humbly answered back, "I am the Lord's servant. May it be to me as you have said." Then the angel was gone. At first, I was confused. If what the angel said was true, and of course I believed the angel, why had God chosen me? Then I thought of Joseph. How was he going to leave my story? If I was a child, surely he wanted to divorce me. My confusion became fear. Fear of losing Joseph, and fear of public disgrace. But those fears were necessary, because an angel also appeared to Joseph and told him that the child in me was from the Holy Spirit. The angel also told Joseph to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. But before they So Joseph did what the angel had commanded him and did not sign divorce papers, but took me home as his wife. But before the baby was born, Caesar Augustus ordered a census to be taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone in it was to go and register to the town of their ancestors. Since Joseph and Manasseh belonged to the house and line of David, went up from Nazareth in Galilee to Bethlehem in Judea, the house of David. It was a 3-day trip from Nazareth, and was hard since I was soon to give birth. But we kept going, for we knew God was with us.
Oh, that road to Bethlehem. It was a rough trip for Mary and Joseph. Mary seemed so awkward and uncomfortable, but she was such a trooper.
And Joseph, too. He traveled with a heavy heart, not certain what God was asking of him, nor why God had chosen him, but with all the questioning, he was still obedient.
And us, too. Remember how we did our part? We beamed and twinkled with all our might all the nights when Mary and Joseph were on the road to Bethlehem.
I'm sure you gave it all you had, Twink, but face it, that wasn't your special day. You were not the brightest in the sky.
Okay, fact is, I did all I could, and I still remember the last night of that long trip, Joseph looked toward the heavens and seemed to be pleading with God. And Mary was so tired, but even so, sitting there on the donkey, she looked up into the sky and smiled. We wanted them to feel God's love through us, and I think it worked.
Thank you.
The Savior was born, and the world needed to know. Jesus had arrived to fulfill God's promise, and the angels waited for the signal to proclaim the birth.
I like this part of the story, those unsuspecting shepherds. They were about to learn that the greatest event of the ages had just taken place.
That's right, and they were the very first to hear the great news. Mary and Joseph finally arrived in Bethlehem, and this is where my story really gets exciting. They were in the town of Bethlehem, Mary, a humble maidservant, and Joseph, a most obedient man of God. Arriving on their donkey into a crowded village, they went into the inn to stay for the night, but it was full.
That's not exciting, Twink. That's sad. The innkeeper could only give them shelter in the stable. The Son of God, the Messiah, the Savior of the world was about to be born, and the best they could find was a lowly stable?
That's just it. No celebration, no welcoming party, not even a comfortable bed.
So, Twink, tell us again, why does this part of the story always excite you?
Because it was all part of God's plan. The people expected their deliverer to be a Messiah of royalty, but instead, he came from the humblest of beginnings. Stable, Mary gave birth to a baby boy. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in the manger. Can you believe that? God exchanged a throne in heaven for a manger of hay.
And don't forget his companions. I like that part of your story.
Hold on, I'm getting to that. Like I said, God exchanged a throne in heaven for the manger. And he exchanged the companionship of adoring angels for the presence of humble animals.
And Mary and Joseph?
Chill, I'm getting to that too. Joseph, steadfast in faithfulness and obedience, and Mary, dear sweet Mary, was rocking her baby in Bethlehem.
Sing sweet and low your lullaby till angels say amen. A mother tonight is rocking cradle in Bethlehem. While wise men fall through the dark, a star that beacons them. A mother tonight is rocking cradle in Bethlehem. A little child shall lead them, the prophet said of old. In storm and tempest keep them till the bells tolled. Sing sweet and low your lullaby till angels say amen. A mother tonight is rocking cradle in Bethlehem.
The Savior was born and the world needed to know. Jesus had arrived to fulfill God's promise and the angels waited for the signal to proclaim the birth.
I like this part of the story, those unsuspecting shepherds. They were about to learn that the greatest event of the ages had just taken place.
That's right, and they were the very first to hear the great news. The shepherds, who would have thought? Just another part of God's plan that was so not what the people expected.
Did you see my sheep?
Did you see my sheep?
Have you seen my sheep? Have you seen my sheep? Have you seen my sheep?
What an amazing, peaceful night.
Yeah, dude, look at the stars.
Because the angel said so, that's why. Come on. Wait, stop. Who's going to watch the sheep?
Oh, yeah, our sheep. Who'll watch them?
Duh, the angels will. Let's go.
Man, did those shepherds hurry to Bethlehem. And there they found baby Jesus, just as the angels had said, lying in a manger.
And then they began to spread the news to everyone.
Right, I remember. Amazed. That was the only word to describe their reaction.
All but Mary. She had heard the words of Gabriel. She heard what the angel told Joseph. So when she heard the shepherds speak of the divinity of her baby, it was something she already knew.
Yeah, she knew, but she didn't know.
Huh? I don't get it. You're going to have to explain that one, Twink. Knew, but didn't know?
Mary treasured all the things she heard. She pondered them in her heart. You see, Mary knew she had given birth to the Son of God, just as the angels had told her. But the rest, I don't think she knew. That night in the stable with her baby boy, how could she know? The shepherds were singing praises and glorifying God, and in the midst of this, as we watched from above, God said that my special time had come. It was time for me to shine.
And that's when you said, what? Now? Here?
Okay, my bad. For thousands of years I had waited, but I didn't know what I was waiting for. But when God said, shine, shine I did. I moved lower in the sky, and then I stopped over the stable where Jesus lay. And I shone with a power I never knew I had. My light beamed into the world, and my light announced the coming of the Savior.
And the three kings looked up and saw you. They were expecting a sign for the coming of the Messiah, and when they saw your light, they knew.
Yep, the wise men knew that it was worth the sacrifice of their time, energy, and treasures for all the sake of bowing and worshiping a new king. When they saw me beaming, they packed their bags, gathered their gifts, checked their maps, grabbed their tent, and hit the road.
I'm on the road, dog. Got my backpack, Max on the road, dog. If you could see what we see, you would want to go where we're going just to be where we'll be. In the spirit of more than a baby boy, the Lord who can save you and save me all. Maybe if it's still not clear, let wise men open your eyes and take you there.
I'm on the road, dog. Got my backpack, maps, and my road, dog.
If you could see what we see, you would want to go where we're going just to be where we'll be. In the presence of more than a baby boy, the Lord who can save you and save me. Or maybe if it's still not clear, let wise men open your eyes and take you there. I'm on the road, dog. Got my backpack, maps on the road, dog. If you could see what we see, you would want to go where we're going just to be where we'll be. In the presence of more than a baby boy, the Lord who can save you and save me. Or maybe if it's still not clear, let wise men open your eyes and take you there.
The wise men knew that they were standing in the presence of more than just a baby boy. The wise men knew that the baby Jesus was their Lord and Savior. And it had all happened just as the prophets had said hundreds of years earlier.
Yes, the greatest event in all of history took place that night in Bethlehem.
That night, I beamed above the stable. It was the light that God used to signify the coming of Messiah, Savior of mankind. But my light, shining brighter than it ever had, was no match for the light of the world.
God gave you a special job, Twink, and you did it well. As the angels sang and the stars shone above, God revealed his glory and his love by giving the greatest gift to all of mankind.
And later, Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but I will have the light of life." God's gift to all mankind was the light of life, a life of hope, of joy, and of peace. Man does not have to walk in darkness because the light of God's Son can overcome the darkness and light the path of righteousness.
So girls, that is the story of Twink the Christmas Star. Every year we put the star on the top of our tree to remind us that Jesus came into the world as the light that could overcome darkness and save us. The tiny baby born on Christmas Day in Bethlehem is still today the Savior of the world.
Twink was so lucky to have such a big job.
You're right, Kate, but just like God created Twink for a special job, he has a special job for each of us.
Oh, I know what that is. I remember my job, to shine for Jesus.
That's right, Millie. Jesus wants each of us to shine for him.
Come here, Millie, my little star. It's finally time to put the star on the tree.
And Kate, it's your turn to set up the nativity scene.
They saw the light in the darkness. It shines on us in tenderness. It brings out the hope that's in all of us. May it shine its light on you this Christmas night. They saw the light in the darkness. It shines on us in tenderness. It brings out the hope that's in all of us. May it shine its light on you this Christmas night.
The stable was the light that brings out the hope in all of us. As Mary held baby Jesus, I asked her, Mary, do you know who you hold? You hold the glory of heaven. He who is ageless is now only moments old. He who walked among the stars now has legs too weak to stand. The hands that created the oceans are now an infant's tiny fists. Mary, you hold the Son of God. You hold the light of the world. Those tiny fists would grow, and they would, in time, be nailed to a cross. Jesus' blood would be shed so that the sins of all who believe in him could be forgiven. And whoever follows him would never walk in darkness, but have the light of life. Born in the humble stable, born in the humble stable was the light that brings out the hope in all of us. It is still the light that till this day is the light in the darkness. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. May his light shine on your Christmas night.
Long, long ago, in a world dark and cold, nights so still, winter's chill, one bright star was shining on a bed made of hay. In a manger he lay. Shepherds came, they knew his name. King of kings, a brand new day. They saw the light in the darkness. It shines on us in tenderness. It brings out the hope that's in all of us. May it shine its light on you this Christmas night. Would you stand and sing this last verse with me? Let's sing together on this Christmas day. On this Christmas day, may that star light your way. This Christmas Eve, I still believe that same star still shines on me. They saw the light in the darkness. It shines on us in tenderness. It brings out the hope that's in all of us. May it shine its light on you this Christmas night. May it shine its light on you this Christmas night.
I think all of you ought to take a bow and let them applaud one more time. Would you do that? Take a bow. Thank you, thank you. These you see on the stage, what an immense amount of work they've put in to make this day a special day, and they've done it for the glory of the Lord, and we thank each one of them. There are people behind the scenes that you did not see on the stage this morning. The principal of those being Lisa Shablowski. Where is Lisa? Where is Lisa? Come on up here. You're finished back there. You're finished back there. And I know Jackie was helping with the costuming and all of these things. Suzanne operating that spotlight. She doesn't want to be in the spotlight. She just wants to operate it. So Katie helping the kids. And all the rest of you that were involved in this, please come. Please come up here. Do this for me. You had to turn around and look where the angel was standing. Look at the angels that are up there now, if you would. Rohan's going to set down, and Rohan and Chip and all of the others that were taking care of these things. What a blessing. What privilege it was just to be here today and to be able to experience this. And John for leading our music and doing so much and adjusting microphones for those that were tall and short and all of this. So John, thank you so much. And I'm sure I'm going to leave somebody else out. But if there's anybody else in the building that had anything to do with this, come on up, okay? I don't want to leave you out. But God bless you. Thank you for coming. And now that all of these are up here, let's give them one more round of applause and just give them our appreciation. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. God bless you. Thank you for being here. We want to invite you to a time of fellowship with us right after this. So these will be there for you to let them, for you to give them high fives and tell them what a good job they did, because indeed they have this morning excelled. And it is our prayer for you this Christmas. It is our prayer that in your life that Jesus might be glorified every day. You know, it's only 10 days until we celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we're in the countdown now. And so every day that you do, just count it all joy and count it all to his glory, everything that takes place. And let this season be not about us, but about Him. And let us begin each day by worshiping Him. Let us begin each day by giving Him glory. And let this play that has been put on this morning and all the message of it, let that be in your mind and in your memory so that you might be able to glorify Him. So may you go forth from this place with joy, even as Jesus has come to give us joy. May you go forth from this place following that light, because Jesus is indeed the light of the world. He's come that we might not be in darkness, but that we might know Him in His light. So God bless you each one. May He multiply His blessings to you each day. Join us if you would for a time of fellowship. All of you guys come and be here with us so that we can let you know our joy. God bless you. You're dismissed.